I'm Sarah, and I work for Girl Scouts of the USA. I'm also a troop leader, and I live in Brooklyn, New York, and I'm part of the Girl Scouts of Greater New York Council. Today, we're going to be talking about wilderness injuries and how to potentially treat them. The whole activity should only take about an hour, and you'll need only a few very simple supplies. You'll need a computer or a tablet or a phone with internet access. You'll need a piece of paper, something to write with, and ideally a note card, although that isn't required. You can just use your regular paper, but something a little more sturdy and durable might be a good idea. First, you're going to need your piece of paper and a pencil. I want you to make a list of all the things you love doing outside. So if it's boating or kayaking or snowboarding or hiking or camping, whatever it is, make a list of what those things are. And sort of at the end, once you're done with that, rank them into your top, five or so. So pause this video, take a moment, and do that. Now you have your list of your five favorite things to do out in nature. Now I want you to look at it and create a little scenario for each of them, of an emergency that might happen or an injury that might happen when you're out doing whatever that activity is. So I wrote one for myself. So I love to go hiking. So my scenario is, I'm imagining I'm out hiking with my friends and family. The scenery is gorgeous and there isn't another group of hikers anywhere close. I'm miles away from the nearest town. Suddenly, one of my friends steps off the path, twists an ankle, and takes a hard fall. I think her ankle might be broken. What do I do? So go back, look at your list, write your little scenarios with your big question, and then come back. But pause this video, but definitely come back. Last step. Now you need to do some research and find out the answers to those questions that you just listed. So pull out your phone or your tablet or your computer, whatever it is that you use to go online and do some research, and start pulling up resources from search and rescue teams, first aid websites. The Red Cross is a great resource. And also think about whether or not there's anybody you want to call or email or text to get some information on whatever your favorite activities might be. But as you're doing this research, I want you to answer four questions. One, how do the professionals treat those injuries? Two, how can you get help if someone is injured in the wilderness? So who do you go to get help? And that's gonna change depending on what your activities are. So whether or not you're boating, or you're skiing, or you're hiking, that might be a different sort of chain of who you call and how you get there. So find out the answer to that. Three, what you should do as a non-medical professional while you're waiting for help to arrive. So what can you do? And then take some time to practice whatever that is. And then fourth, what simple supplies do you need to make sure are in your pack at all times so that you're ready in case these emergencies arise? Once you find the answers to those four questions, write them down in a note card and put them in your pack or whatever it is that you bring when you're out having your outdoor adventures, because you don't want to have to be digging back into your memory for this activity to remember what it is you're supposed to be doing. Have it on hand. You're doing the work right now. Write it down, tuck it in your pack, and it's there if you ever need it. Once you have completed this, you'll have completed a step to earning the Girls Are Superheroes patch. There are two other activities to be done to earn this patch. You can go to girlscouts.org/superheroes to find out what the other two steps are. And I hope if you enjoyed this activity, you'll share it with your friends. And if you're not already a Girl Scout, that you'll consider joining. So to do that, you can reach out to a local council, you can reach out to another girl who might be a member, or you can go to girlscouts.org. To find out more information, there's tons of info online and places to ask questions and ways to find a troop. So thank you so much. I hope you had a great time. Now go online and research and write down what you find and make sure you put it in your pack so you have it when you need it.